Welcome back, everybody. Now we're going to be talking about a serious issue with kind of a happy ending. We're going to be talking about breast cancer and how it's the second leading cause of cancer death among women, exceeded only by lung cancer.
Mm-hmm. Unbelievable.
That is scary. Right? Your own chest kills you.
It's crazy. When I heard it was lung cancer, the leading cause for women, I thought, wow, does that have a lot to do with smoking and whether or not, are we smokers?
No, I thought the same thing. Oh, I'm not.
Wow. I'm not either, but no. Thank God. Makes me wonder, you know?
Right.
Sometimes maybe like from history that you have in your family that might bring it along.
Right.
Hereditary.
That was very, very surprising to me that lung cancer was number one.
Yeah, me too.
And as we're honoring breast cancer survivors today, several years ago I had the pleasure of meeting a fantastic photographer and an artist, and his name is Michael Colanero. And now, today, he's heading a beautiful project with breast cancer survivor women. And I'm going to basically open the floor. Hi, Michael.
Hi, Stella. How are you
He's
doing?
Here
nice
today.
To see you again.
Nice to see you.
Welcome.
With Uta and Dawn. Welcome to everybody.
Welcome.
Michael, why don't you tell us about how it all started and what you're up to today. And you know, first of all, before I let you say anything, I'm going to encourage everybody that's watching to really pay attention and find out ways and how you can get involved and help Michael, because he has a beautiful cause and he's doing it all by himself. So, you know, just listen up and pay attention and see how you can get involved. Go ahead,
Great.
Michael.
It's called the Breast Cancer Awareness Body Painting Project. And basically we're taking breast cancer survivors of all ages and backgrounds from all around the world. We're accepting applications. All different stages of reconstruction, no reconstruction, you know. And I come up with designs that are specifically tailored to each woman and her story, either their passions in their life or their breast cancer story. Mm-hmm. And then we try to make these designs that then also appeal to the larger breast cancer story.
Right.
And these are two other survivors that have been painted for the project so far.
Absolutely.
Dawn's is finished already. Hers is called Tribute. And Uta's is still in production, and hers should be released very shortly, actually.
Oh, my goodness.
How exciting.
Yeah. And, you know, one other impactful statistic is that there's 2.5 million cancer survivors, breast cancer survivors in the United States today. And that includes women that are in treatment and that have made it through. And I think that's really powerful to know that we're blessed with these inspirational women. And go ahead.
1 in 8 women will be diagnosed in their lifetime.
Imagine that.
You're kidding.
Goodness.
No. 1 in 8?
God forbid.
Oh,
that's so
I didn't
sad.
Know it was that common.
That is so scary.
Right.
It's scary. 1 of 8.
And, you know, I wanted to take an opportunity to have you ladies share with us your story as much as you're comfortable sharing. You want to start, Dawn?
Sure.
Okay. And as you talk, please talk to the audience and that camera. Okay.
For me, my picture was, I flew for about 17 years, so for me, it was my passion of flying, being from New York, and the diagnosis of breast cancer and my picture, how something like that could just change your life.
Mm-hmm.
And when I came across this project, for me, it was heartfelt in a way where breast cancer changes your body. And when I did this project, it kind of brought me back to life.
Right.
It made me feel alive. Mm-hmm. And it empowered me.
Right.
I could see how we do that.
Yeah.
That's one of the really great things. You know, there's so many groups out there that are raising funding and raising awareness and different things. And this project, we're actually really like healing spirits and people from the inside out. We've had people that have submitted applications to the project that say, you know, I really have not looked in the mirror in 7 years.
Yes.
And they come in and they're painted, and I have photos of them just staring at themselves in the mirror for the first time. And it's very intense. It's a long day. It takes several hours to be painted. I do a lot of post-production work to the images. Some of them are photographed very close to how they're painted, and some of them get a lot of work after, although I don't really change the bodies of the women unless there's something that they're self-conscious about, then maybe I might de-accentuate a scar. But it's really, you know, like the hands of a worker show their stories, these are about the women and what they've been through.
Right.
And
right.
So we want to be realistic and portray that.
And Dawn, you picked the scene that you picked, and explain to us why, because of the flying that you've done before and...
Yeah, well, Michael helped me with that.
Mm-hmm.
Michael just really heard my story, and I told him what was important to me and about my background. And he came up with this beautiful story.
Right, right.
Her piece features the Twin Towers from New York because she's from New York.
Okay.
And because she had so much years in flying experience. And I don't know that, was it not crews that you worked with, but people that you knew through different things
were
actually went into the towers themselves.
Uh-huh. Oh,
and
wow.
Her image is not just really about, it's obviously a tribute to Americans and America, but also breast cancer survivors, obviously. And New Yorkers, but it's more about the larger story of anything can happen to you out of the blue and completely change your life.
Mm-hmm.
And that's really kind of what that
And it's
that
happened
piece
to you more
about.
Than once that something has just kind of come out and changed your life out of the blue.
Yeah. But you know, you all survive.
And you're here. Yeah. I mean, I'm so glad you're here. It's you see,
incredible.
Like I know.
It'll be 5 years this summer.
Congratulations.
Are you cancer free?
Yes.
Yes.
That's
awesome.
That's
congratulations.
That's great.
Beautiful. And so just go ahead, Michael.
So far we've had 23 women from all across the country, and one woman came from Australia.
Mm-hmm.
They've been painted and photographed, and I'm on target to do 50 for a coffee table book, and hopefully if we can get some sponsors, we'd like to do a national gallery tour.
Mm-hmm. And you know, like Michael said, there's a lot of projects out there that are supporting breast cancer and cancer in itself, and you know, a lot of walks and runs and everything. And the reason why this project was so appealing to me was because it uses art, and I think art can be very therapeutic, you know, not just looking at art and doing art, but also being the canvas, you know. And I think that, you know, with cancer you deal with a lot of shame, a lot of healing that has to happen, and sometimes I'm just saying this, and correct me if I'm wrong, just being able to expose your body and say, you know what, this is me. Mm-hmm. This is the new me, and you know, hear me roar.
That's
and
right.
then, you know, that can be so healing, correct?
Very therapeutic.
Absolutely. Uta, why don't you go ahead and tell us about your story?
Well, I got diagnosed 2 years ago in 2009.
Okay.
And it was devastating.
Yes.
And I had a double mastectomy, so when I was younger, I never could imagine myself with no breasts, but thanks God to plastic surgery.
Yes.
We have them now.
Amen.
And then.
Yes. I say that too. Yes.
Yeah.
Of course.
So, and
go ahead, plastic surgery. Yes.
And fulfill yourself. I mean, because sometimes it's like you don't feel comfortable with your body, but if there's like a little hand that could help.
Yes.
Yay.
Yeah.
So that was one of the ups. So I could go bigger than I was before.
Yay.
Even so. And Michael chose actually a very sexy motif for me. Yeah, it was a corset.
Yeah, she's very she's so lean and everything already.
Yes. And you know, we can't see the image yet because it's in the process of being done.
But she really looks like she's wearing a corset when she's not. So
we're
planning to be very much like a corset.
And the
pink ribbons.
The negative thing was he colored me on a Tuesday night where there was nothing going on. So I had to go from house to house of my friends and showed my corset. And I slept in it. So.
Oh, yes.
It's amazing. So many of the women, there's at the studio we were doing the photography, there's a shower, but only one woman showered. Everybody else left.
Mm-hmm. Oh, I
want to
One girl went to Miami Beach, painted that way. And,
oh, my God. Well, that's too much.
Yeah, you know, we're in Miami. Anything goes. People won't look twice, right?
And it took how long to paint you?
I think 2.5 hours.
2.5 hours.
Yeah.
Wow.
Why would you wash that off right away?
Exactly.
Yeah, it takes a while. Some of them are, you know, 3-4 hours a piece. And then what I do is I'm selling, obviously the target of the coffee table book will be each woman will have a full page of their image, and then the opposite page will be their story and their bio.
Excellent.
So it's really, the pictures are really just to keep you turning the pages to read the stories.
Mm-hmm.
Because the women are the story of the project.
Of course.
Of course.
You know, it's a human element.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah. And then I'm doing fine art prints. Mm-hmm. Of the pieces, and then we also, I've taken all of the images and online, they're on mouse pads and coffee mugs and t-shirts.
Goodness.
And all of the products that are online donate 100% of the profits to breast cancer causes.
Wow. And what is the website?
Yeah, that's on Cafe Press. It's cafepress.com/BCABPP for the Breast Cancer Awareness Body Painting.
Say that one more time, please.
cafepress.com/BCABPP.
Very good.
And if you want to find any of the other, we're on Flickr, we're on Twitter, we're on YouTube. We have a great group on Facebook. where the survivors are actually tagged, and you can comment back and forth on the images with them, and it's really a great support community as well.
And you know, I'm going to give you ladies an opportunity. If there's anybody out there that is watching this and that has gone through reconstructive surgery, or perhaps the surgery in itself, and it's wondering, you know, should I do this project? Should I call Michael and reach out and see if I can get body painted? How would you, what would you tell them to encourage them to do that? What did they, what did it do to you, for you, basically? Go and start, Dawn.
For me, it made me feel like a woman again.
Okay.
So, I mean, I could start crying. It's just, it was very touching.
Don't cry.
No, it's okay. Let her.
It did, it made me feel very sexy.
Mm-hmm. So it took away a lot of the inhibitions that you had before. And now you feel like it freed you of some of that burden. It's okay. No, this is great.
Oh my God,
this is
great. You're yes. great.
It's okay.
It's okay. I mean, thank you're you. Here. You're alive. Thanks.
No, we like that reaction. Yeah. We like to see that people yeah. are feeling good about themselves.
Yeah, look what you did to her. Yeah.
No. See?
You gave her life back. But,
yes.
And he created a family.
Yeah.
We're a family.
The project, it's a support. All of the survivors in the project is really like an extended family now.
Yes.
They all support each other.
Oh,
it's really
goodness.
Amazing.
Yes. And that's
Uta,
so important.
Tell us.
Well, it was a very nice day for me. Michael makes us very comfortable. Mm-hmm. We can bring friends, we can bring food, whatever. And
you're nurtured.
You are nurtured. And it's a fun day. You
uh-huh.
know, we took a lot of pictures besides getting videotaped. And it was nice. It was freeing. And like with Michael said, I felt very sexy.
Awesome.
I brought a lot of clothes with me, so different
you
kind of pants to wear, you know, with to make the pictures a little, you know,
very
like different. So it was sexy and freeing, fulfilling, okay. and yeah,
amazing.
It was, oh.
Thank you so much, ladies.
Thank you very much.
Thank you for the opportunity.
So
we need all the
guys,
exposure
like
and help that we can get
yes.
to get
oh,
out
absolutely.
There.
Oh, absolutely. And any information will be on our Facebook page as well, facebook.com/insighttalkshow, if you're interested and you can't find it anywhere
become
else.
A fan.
Yes, become a fan and become a fan of this beautiful project.
Support. That's what
thank
they
you
need.
So much. And again, until next time.